Once you've logged into GreenGlass, you'll see two primary navigational tabs, Collection and Analysis. Click here to find the GreenGlass Collection Visualization Tool. This part of the application is designed to help you see and understand your collection in new ways and to prepare you for interaction with the GreenGlass Query Builder. The first view of your monographs collection will always be an LC and/or NLM subject distribution. Notice that the vertical axis indicates number of items. As we mouse over each bar in the chart, the legend above the chart displays the exact number of items held in each class. While the LC class distribution is the first one you'll see, there are several others. Your view is changed via the distribution menu here. If your collection, or a significant portion of your collection, is cataloged in Dewey, your second distribution option will be the Dewey 100s. For the moment, we'll retain the LC class distribution and select the Recorded Uses overlay to get a general sense about relative usage by subject. The bright green portion of each bar represents items with three or more recorded uses. The middle green portion of each bar represents items with two recorded uses, and the dark green portion represents items with just one recorded use. The black bottom of each bar represents that part of the collection for which there are no recorded uses. If we choose a distribution of recorded uses, we see that more than 759,000 items fall into the category of zero recorded uses. More than 389,000 have one recorded use, 258,000 have two recorded uses, and so on. We can also see that nearly 399,000 items in this collection have more than 10 recorded uses. If we now select the HathiTrust overlay, we can see that a big swath of this library's titles are also represented in HathiTrust. The bright green represents titles that are in the public domain, and the darker green represents items that are still in copyright. The black base of each bar represents titles that are not in the Hathi corpus. We'll choose the publication year distribution for a window into the age of the collection. If we then select the choice overlay, we can see that choice has been identifying high-quality monographs since about 1987. Since then, between 10 and 15% of all titles acquired by this library have been reviewed in choice, which some libraries may choose to retain regardless of usage or other attributes. Our hope is that by learning about your collection via these many viewpoints, you will be positioned to use the GreenGlass Query Tool to full advantage. Note that if we scroll down the collection page, we'll see the charted data in tabular form. Item tallies in the far right column are linked to corresponding lists of items. If, for example, we want to see a list of items that were published before 1920, we would simply click on this tally.